Welcome to a tutorial about aligning stereoscopic images in Fusion, or any other compositing program for that matter, even Photoshop. As you probably know, there are lots of things that can give the viewer a headache when it comes to stereoscopic footage. The most important one is vertical alignment. Here are two photos I took handheld with my mobile phone. As you can see, the right eye is not only shifted, it's also rotated quite a bit. If you have such a misaligned stereo rig on your project, I hope you're in a position to fire the DOP, but even slight vertical misalignment is detrimental, so here's how you fix it. There are many ways to set up an anaglyph view in Fusion. An elegant one is to use the A and B buffers of the viewer. Put the left eye into the A buffer and the right eye into B. You can see the misalignment in the split wipe. Then, enable the stereo button and click the AB source option. Now there's your anaglyph. The monochrome version, while not sophisticated, is perfect for judging the alignment of the two images. Zoom into one corner. The bottom right one is a good choice here because it features a distinct piece of rock. Add a transform tool to the right eye. You could also modify the other one, but from my experience, the industry standard is to leave the left eye untouched as much as possible while doing all the warping to the right eye. Let's start aligning the two images vertically. Since the transform widget is off screen, you have to hold down the Alt key while dragging the image in the viewport. It's a nifty little feature, and so is auto proxy, but it gets in the way right now. Of course, we don't want any horizontal movement. You can just type 0.5 into the X field. Another way to nudge the image around is by using the cursor keys, but this position already looks fine. The next step is to look at the opposite corner. In this example, that's the top left corner. And of course, there is vertical misalignment, which could even be worse than before. This, however, will be fixed by rotating the image. The center of rotation has to be the corner we have aligned previously. We don't want it to move away again. Select the transform's pivot by pressing the tab key repeatedly until the thin crosshair is highlighted. Then you can move the pivot onto the rock at the bottom right corner. Now zoom back into the top left corner and adjust the angle of rotation. Dragging the slider is much too coarse. By using the cursor keys left and right, the angle can be adjusted in smaller steps. You could even hold down the control key for even finer adjustments. There. The features line up vertically, and in this case, the horizontal disparity of the tree is almost zero as well. This, however, is just chance and doesn't have to be the case in your shot, nor is it required for performing vertical alignment. Let's check the remaining corners to see if the plates are now aligned. Yep, the bottom left one looks good enough. And the top right corner is also perfectly aligned. In case there is still vertical misalignment, you could try scaling or using a corner pin in addition to the transform tool. To get rid of the edge issue, you will need to crop the images or fill the pixels somehow. Usually there's some headroom anyways to do depth grading later on, or the whole movie is being scaled up slightly in the end. This is the annotated comp that can be downloaded from my website. I have stacked the images horizontally so you can try free viewing them. Or you can play back this node here, which toggles between left and right eye continuously. See how bad the stereo pair used to look before it was aligned? Alright, that's all folks. Thanks for watching.